once upon a time, in the land of Burbank, California, lives a building under the name of Walt Disney Animation Studios. For years since 1923, they've held up a reputation of entertaining generations with their timeless classics that reside in their animation library. But then, one autumn's night, November 1991, Disney released an animated feature that would bring a change in them. That feature was Beauty and the Beast. This tale as old as time was and still remembered from audiences and critics alike, even receiving the honor as not only one of the greatest animated films of all time, but also holding the title of being the first animated feature to be nominated for Best Picture at the Academy Awards. The success doesn't end there. Disney decided to bring the most beautiful love story ever told to the stages of New York. The Beauty and the Beast musical ran from 1994 to 2007 and is the 10th longest running show in Broadway history. Like the source material, the show was just as successful and beloved by critics and audiences, to the point where Disney decided to give the same treatment to their other classic films later on down the line. Even if it's no longer running on Broadway, the musical is still being performed to this day, ranging from schools to community theaters. However, whenever a school or a theater decides to put on this show, there's anything but despair, a great level of doubt and hope, and a greater question that's always on the creative team's mind. For how does a community recreate that Broadway magic?
This was the show that in 2005 really was the turning point for the theater.
My experience with Beauty and the Beast comes from the fact that when I first did the show back in 2005, we were one of the first amateur or non-professional productions of Beauty and the Beast in the country, especially in community theater environments.
Probably its scale, its scope. We've done a lot of big shows this season, but I have to admit, Beauty and the Beast is by far the largest scale musical as far as where we decided to take the production. Definitely a full-fledged spectacle production.
It's vastly different. It is our only Disney show, and I think that alone makes a big difference. Disney is just a completely different vibe from any sort of contemporary show happening.
We have a cast of 79. There's a big spectacle production value. The set is immense and it's just gorgeous to look at. There are 274 costumes that are dripping with glitz and enchantment. It's a fun family musical. We know that audiences of all ages should have a good time when they're here. So it really does have that mass appeal from child to adult.
It's a fairy tale. It's just larger than life and very elegant and extravagant and kind of blends the elements of both the cartoon and the live action version.
I love being involved with Springfield Little Theatre because I love to see the connections that people make with each other, even with during the rehearsal process. Directors are really good about pushing their actors to new heights that they never knew they could reach, and they're really good about pushing the technical staff to new heights they never knew they could reach. I have learned so many new skills this season alone just to be able to make the magic happen.
Every show is different. Every show I learn something new. I learn a different technique on making props, or I learn how to build something else, or I learn about sound or about lights, and I love learning new things. And I love creating a show, and I love that it's never the same show twice.
I grew up with it, so it's kind of like a second home.
almost, so it's like natural.
Theater really cannot be anything if we're not all working together towards the end goal. They say that the ensemble and the crew are what make or break a show, and that is so definitely true. The leads are important and their jobs are incredibly important, but the ensemble and the crew are what keeps everything moving and going and running, and just there's so much community and teamwork here that it's really incredible.
This place is so different than any other theater. It's such a strong family here, and once you come in and you're on this stage or running a fly, you're part of the family. And once you volunteer once, you're part of the family for life. And I think that's pretty special to find in a community theater.
The obstacles that we faced on Beauty and the Beast this time around from when we did it in 2005 is it's just bigger. We're doing a different style. When we did it back in 2005, we kind of relied on the cartoon. So when you design a cartoon, it's a lot different in style than you would have if you were designing a realistic Shakespearean piece or tragedy or something like that. But this production, we kind of went towards the live action film a little bit more, which allows us to go with a different color palette, allows us to go with different levels of realism, which I think is something we are getting a little bit more realism in this production than just reflection of 2D cartoon.
This show has a lot of personal meaning to me. It's very, very, very special. And so I had a lot of emotional mental blocks to like allow myself to be vulnerable in my part. But once I was able to get past those obstacles and really work through them, they were not only, you know, impacted my performance on stage, but they've also just benefited me in my personal life.
This was such a huge role for me that I kind of got in my own way a little bit. I second-guessed myself a lot, and it was really hard for me to trust myself because I didn't want to let myself down and anyone else down because this role meant so much to me. But I've learned how to do it, and I've learned to like love myself even more now through this character. That's how much like it affected me.
Being on my side of the stage, most of the techies are all like teenage boys, which is difficult because they're, you know how teenage boys can be. And the amount of cast members is just, there's not a lot of space backstage, so having very little space is also difficult.
Having to learn new things, having to do new techniques and new things that we've never done before, always doing something new. You think, oh, I can do this and it'll be really fast. And then you realize, oh, this is actually a long process, or I've messed it up my first try and so I have to do it again. So trial and error.
Yeah, I mean, there's always a couple of bibbles and bobbles, but that's the magic of theater.
Favorite part about the show is the Beauty and the Beast number. Whenever Belle walks down those stairs in that beautiful yellow dress. Belle's dress, I think it's absolutely stunning.
It's really hard to pick one, but I really think that the whole story of it is beautiful, and it's always going to be poignant, and it's always going to be truthful here. It's always going to be relevant, and that's what I love about it.
I love books, I love to read, so the story itself and the fact that Belle loves to read and that there's a big magical library is has always been my favorite thing about Beauty and the Beast.
The song, A Change in Me, that is a beautiful song. I think anybody that's grown up and dealt with life can relate to that song.
Every part in the show has to be our guest. It's the blowout standout number, so that's spectacular.
My favorite part about Beauty and the Beast is that it is just, I think, arguably one of the most magical shows to come on stage. And who doesn't want to see an incredible transformation at the end of a show? Who doesn't want to see incredible set pieces that move around, see the lighting? It just all together is just a magical, magical package.
We'll go down as a classical musical theater history. You know, it'll go down like Oklahoma, like Anything Goes, like Gypsy, like all of the famous classical musicals. It will go down as a classical musical. And who doesn't love a great classical musical? It's it's a different type of family for sure, but where else do you get to meet an entirely different group of people every seven shows? I think that we do a tremendously professional job here at Springfield Little Theatre. And so every season we try to stretch ourselves and try to become better professionally and try to become better as artists. And doing that just keeps you coming back and keeps you wanting more.
This place means so much to me, and I want to help it grow even more. That's why I want to stay.
Family, they're my home away from home. Sometimes I like forget that this like isn't my home.
Because I love it. And I want to see this theater succeed. I'm proud of what we've done. I'm proud of the staff. I'm proud of the fact that we're one of the top community theaters in the nation. People are passionate about what they do. I love the fact that people find their tribe here and feel comfortable. I think that's very important.
I work with some pretty great people here at Springfield Little Theatre, and that's what's keeping me here. I could do theatre in a lot of places in a lot of cities, but somehow I just don't think it would be appreciated quite so much as here in Springfield, where we need theatre to thrive.
It's made me want to stay a part of things just so I can have a little small piece and, you know, saying, oh, I helped make this show and I helped do this thing, and that was so magical and so wonderful. Happy.
I think it's just wanting to be around the people and continue to be a part of the environment. Not wanting to lose that part of myself, I guess.
This show means a lot to me because it really shows that you shouldn't judge a book by its cover. And I think that is a really important message. Society.
The storyline of finding yourself and not necessarily changing your ways, but you know, seeing another side of a story. It's a good lesson to learn, is being able to see something from a different angle and being okay with it, which is kind of what Belle ends up doing.
I think you really do find yourself in every aspect and in every character in the show. Maybe not Gaston so much. It's really fun to laugh at him, and I feel like I've dated him before.
I always have felt like I was the Beast, trying to find my beauty kind of thing. And so it just like affects me in that way. Feeds my everyone, like be our guest. It's exactly what I wanted it to be, and even more. It's perfect. It's also contained. It's just everything you want in a Broadway show.
Belle is a role that my late older brother really wanted to see me play. This was his favorite show. And so when I got to audition, I knew that, like, I knew I wanted to be part of the show for that reason. But especially getting to be Belle has been really impactful, as he always, like, my whole life was just like, can't wait to see you play Belle someday. Can't wait to see you play Belle someday.
Beauty and the Beast is probably one of the first Disney movies that I remember. The cartoon came out when I was 6. A story of, again, a princess who's kind of a bookworm, who loved to read, who everybody thought was different. Something that always kind of resonated with me. This show does the same thing, and in fact brings an element of reading to the musical that the cartoon doesn't have, when Belle finds a book that she reads with the Beast, and that's what brings them together. That's something that really is close to my heart.
Everybody's got an egg. Everybody's wearing an egg somewhere, somehow, some reason. And maybe if we were just a little more patient and a little more kind with each other,